Hello, my name is Samprit Patel, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, we are going to learn about one of the collection data types in Python, that is list. At the end of this video, you'll be able to understand different collection types in Python, and you'll be able to apply list in different applications. Including with the regular data types in Python like int, float, string, boolean, Python does have some collection data types. These collection data types are broadly named as sequence type, set type, mapping types. So sequence types contain list and tuples, the set types contain sets, and the mapping type contains dictionary. So today we will be going through in detail with lists. So list is an ordered sequence of zero or more reference objects. The lists are mutable, that is, the elements of the list can be added, updated, and deleted. For example, the marks of students of 5 subjects and the information of the employee. Now the information of the employee contains employee ID, employee name, employee department, and employee salary. So list can contain elements of variable types. It can contain a string, it can contain a number or a float or a boolean value in a single list. So how to create a list? In list, the elements of the list are enclosed in square brackets. So square bracket denotes that the particular data type assigned to the variable should be a list data type. Each element is separated by commas. Now, if you are using any string as an element in a list, it should appear in between a single quote or a double quote. See the example below. List 1 contains 4 elements, of which physics and chemistry are the string type and 1997 and 2000 are of integer type. Now, physics is enclosed in a single quote and chemistry is enclosed in a double quote. So we'll see an example of creating list and display the list. So say list 1 is equal to, in square brackets, we will define some numbers, say 10, and it is separated by comma, so 10, 20, 30, okay, and we'll print the list using print function. So list 1, we'll just run this code, okay. So here in the element, we have all taken an integer values, so this is the output of the list. Now updating the list, there are 3 ways to update a list. You can directly add an element to the list, you can use append function, or using the index number of the list you can add a new element. Now index number of the list starts with 0, we will see one by one. So we want to add an element to the to this particular list, so we'll say list 1 is equals to, now this is the first type, list 1 plus, you want to add an element, say we'll add 40. So 40 should be again enclosed in square brackets to define that it is an element of the list and it is to be added to list 1. Okay, so now we'll print this again. So see what will be the output for this, we'll run this. Okay, so 40 has been added to the list. Now we will see append function. So to append function, you have to call the variable list 1 dot append and you will say 50. So using append function, the element will be by default added to the end of the list. And now we'll print this so that we can get an output. So list 1. Now you see all the 3 outputs, creating of list, updated the list by adding an element using concatenation operator, that is plus operator, and this is by append function. Now the third type is, we'll add the list using its index value. So list 1, so we have to add at index number 1 is equal to say 15, and we'll print this. Okay, now 15 will be added at the index location 1. Okay, so see, this is the index location 1, this is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So these are the three ways you can update a list. Now moving forward, take a minute and write a code for the following statement. Write a program to create a list that contains the information of the student and display it. So the information will contain its roll number, name, gender, department and marks of 5 subjects. So take a while and try to code for this particular statement. So this statement can be coded in two ways. So these are the solutions, two different solutions. So first one is you can directly add elements to the list using a variable std and you can print it. Or if you want to print it separately specifying the data, then you can use this particular print function. Now we'll see this by doing it. So say student is equals to, the first one was easy. We'll directly jump to the second one so that you can know how to access the variables of the elements of the list. So this is the roll number. The name will be say ABC. Okay. After that, separating by comma, gender will be male. Again, separating by comma, the department will be CSE. Then we have to give the marks of 5 subjects, say 50, 52, 60, 74, and say 55. Okay. So the second solution, print. Now we have to print according to the data that we have to specify. So first we will display roll number. So separating with comma the string, we will pass the index number. So we know the roll number is at the index location 0. So std of 0. Okay. So again separating by comma, you will take a string. So slash n will give it for the new line. And we will display a name of the student, comma, again std of 1, because we know that the location 1 we have the name of the student. After that we have gender, comma, std of 2, that is the location of where the gender element will be stored. After that again slash n, then we have to display department using comma. Again we will say std of, so 0, 1, 2, 3, at the third location we have department of the student. And now we will display the marks of the student. So marks of 5 subjects will be, now you don't need to specify all the index numbers. So we know the marks start from 4 to the end of that element. Okay, so it's just we have forgotten the comma. Okay, so this will specify that from index number 4 to the end of the element, take all the elements, consider all the elements. So we'll just run this. Okay. So see, your roll number is 20, then the name is displayed as ABC. After that, the gender. I guess we are missing something here. Okay, so here it was this big mishap. Okay. So we'll see. Okay, the code is right. So following printout statement is for the given problem statement. Now moving forward, there are some functions that are provided in Python to process list. So first function is index, that finds out the index number of the occurrence of the list. Second one is insert. So at ith position, you can insert the x element. So insert x element in the list in position specified by I. Copy function is used to copy all the elements into a new list. Now extend function, so appends list 1 to list 2. So here it is different. In copy function, it copies all the elements from one list to another, but the extend function concatenates two lists. Count function returns number of occurrences of x in the list. After that, remove function will help you to remove or delete the element of the list. Similarly, pop function will also help you to remove the element of the list, but it will remove the ending element of the list. Sort function will sort the elements in an ascending order. Reverse function will reverse the sequence of the elements of the given list. And clear function will delete all the elements of the list. So here are some examples. You can try these examples as it is. Just you have to specify the x and I wherever it is necessary. These are some references that I have used to create this video: Programming in Python 3 of Pearson Publications and Core Python Programming of DreamTech Press. You can go through these books if you want any help through programming in Python. Thank you.